Summit is a unique initiative of CII, which acts as a bridge between SME borrowers who need capital to sustain or grow their businesses and lenders such as banks and NBFCs. Setting the theme for the summit, I would like to invite Mr. Jyoti Prakash Gadia, co-convener CII Delhi panel on SMEs and finance, to deliver the welcome remarks. Mr. Gadia.
Good morning, everybody. It's absolutely delight to see such large number, and we can all understand the importance of this topic in this time. Every day, I suppose in this last 3-4 months, any newspaper headlines will not come something on the disruption, on the slowdown, or as far as the finance problem, whatever we talk about. So we just wanted to decipher this problem, that why this problem is there, why this problem is actually happening, and what is the root cause of this problem. And since we have invited all the experts from the banking industry, from the ministry, and we will try to see that how we can try to help this problem, how we can decipher this problem. Just a second, Amit, can you just help me out with this? Just, we all understand the importance of MSME, that how much the contribution they have in terms of the economy, in terms of the GDP, in terms of employment rate, in terms of the taxation contribution and everything, but what are we getting in return for them? Let me give you some facts and numbers. There are two basic issues that we will try to touch base as a theme address, that hume kya lagta hai ki do MSME ki basic problem kya hai, and isko hum log answer karne ka chesta karenge. What generally the banks look at before funding, banks look at hundreds of things, sir, but I am just mentioning 4 or 5 things importantly, which is important for any of the MSME. Ki sir, if you bank ke darwaje pe ja rahe hain, to sir ye 4 or 5 cheeze aati, hygiene factor which you should have. There are some ratios which are important, and there is one thumb rule which is also important, which is 20% of the turnover. In some of the cases 20 ka 25% ho sakta, but this is how the bankers on a 99% parlance, sir. Kumar ji must be looking at me and must be wondering, sir, it is not for the bankers like you, because we have an interaction with you, but it is for the all remaining 99% of the bankers. If you talk about that, this is the basic framework in which the bankers work. Now, I will just mention some of the case studies for you. There, I could mention hundreds of them. Main khali 10-12 case study aapko bata deta hu ki sir un case studies mein kya answer hoga. In case pehle baat us ratios abhi hum fulfill karte hain, if you are fulfilling these ratios, then my chances are 3 out of 100 that any MSME will get a loan. This is after fulfilling these ratios, sir. Now we talk about this MSME case study, sir. MSME case study, sir. In case if you talk about the slowdown, it means hame bol rahe ki sir last year se meri koi bhi turnover mein growth nahi hui hai. There is some little bit of a reduced profit. Now what is the banker are going to do with the, whether they are going to retain the same limit, or whether they are going to enhance the same limit, or what is going to be the banker's reaction, sir? There is some capital expansion which has taken place in the MSME, and some sort of a short term fund has got diverted to long term fund, and my current ratio has dropped from 1.33, sir. So company is operating at some level, suppose at a 100 crore level, and they get some, because of the government influence or anything, sir, unko kuch ek 3 times of the work order ek bar achanak mein mil gaya, then how are they going to cope up with this temporary cash flow issues? Sir, company is in a cyclical industry like rig industry or into a retail industry, sir. And uske andar mein that 25% rule, how it will be applicable, sir, where my limit requirement is only 3 to 4 months in a year, and remaining 8 months I may not require the entire limit. So one of my brother company becomes an NPA, where I was a guarantor at 20 years before, sir. और 10 साल पहले मैं कभी गारंटर रहा, और मैंने, या फिर मैंने 10 साल पहले किसी के साथ दोस्ती करी, उसकी कंपनी में मैंने गारंटी दे दी, आज वो कंपनी एनपीओ हो गई, सर. माय कंपनी इज रनिंग फाइन एब्सोल्युटली, सर. व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन दैट केस, सर? माय रेटिंग कंपनी डाउनग्रेडेड मी जस्ट बिकॉज, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ माई परफॉर्मेंस, बट बिकॉज द इंडस्ट्री हैज बीन डाउनग्रेडेड. तो मेरी रेटिंग डाउनग्रेड हो गई, सर. वो मेरी रेटिंग हैज बीन डाउनग्रेडेड बाई 1 notch. Sir, this can be numerous case studies, sir. What is going to happen to all this case study? But what was happening till now was this. all these case studies, sir, sorry, the MSME ko bank adhi directly bhi fund kar raha tha. If any of the MSME which were getting directly funding from the banks also, the maximum rating that any of the good MSME could get, it is BBB. Bank risk weightage for this BBB rating is 100% of their capital risk weightage that the bank has to provide. Now, what was happening for this last 2 to 3 years? This is the indicator of the fact that same MSME used to get a funding from an NBFC at a higher rate of interest, around 15-16%. Wahi NBFC, us MSME ko loan deke, uski rating was, it is one of the highest rating that you could ever imagine. MSME ko khud ki rating uski, it was BBB. NBFC after giving loan to the same MSME which is also in the same rating bracket, MSME ki rating was the highest credit rating. That is why you will see that banks were finding it convenient enough that they would lend to an NBFC and NBFC was going to further lend to the MSME. So this was the cycle which was going on, and this can be also demonstrated by the fact that last 3 years, what is the growth of the MSME credit from the NBFC sector? Now what has happened after September month, when this NBFC ka jo source tha bank, from jahan se wo paise laake MSME ko lend karta tha. Now the source of those NBFCs has got freezed. So this is where the credit squeeze to all the MSME has come in, because bankers cannot directly lend because of the norms that they have prescribed. And MS and all the NBFC doesn't have the fund for them to lend. How are we going to crack this problem which is there? So these are the some of the NPA ratios which we all understand that it is the lowest in terms of the micro and the SME, and NPA ratios are the lowest. This is the credit appraisal time that you used to take apart from other things. This is where NBFCs were funding MSME, NBFCs were getting funds from banks. Due to higher credit rating of the NBFCs, bank were able to lend more because through an NBFC route. These are some of the, I will not get into, we all know about this. Now understand the credit rating issue. Sir, I don't know how this credit rating industry works, because same MSME, adhi hum log direct jaake rating maang rahe hain, to humko ek rating mil rahi hai, aur wohi NBFC ke through, us NBFC jo humko lend kar raha, uski rating itni high kyun ho ja rahi hai sir? So this is where the question mark of the MSME lies. Now, there is one silver lining also for all the MSME which I want to just give you the number crunching, and then we can all have the food for thought. This is the main board listing. In this last 10 years, you can see that how much money has been raised from the main board IPO and how much amount that we have been able to raise. Now look at the SME IPO. After this demonetization, what has happened? This is in 2017-18, you can see that the after the demonetization, the number of issues and the number of amount that is getting raised from the MSME, you will see that the amount has suddenly jumped 4 times. And this is not without any reason. This is the reason, sir. That SME exchange is giving you the maximum return in terms of all the asset classes. It means if you are investing in an MSME, sir, it is not only the banks are going to get their money faster, banks, the NPA ratios are the lowest in terms of the banking, and also the equity market return, we are the highest return giver, sir. So there is something, I suppose, that the MSME are not that type of an untouchable type of a thing that we cannot be touched together, sir, in terms of the return that we are giving to the main market, sir. And this is all because of the digitization, whatever is happening, the MSME, I will not get into all these things. So there are two important points that I would like this conference to ponder upon. Ki how is this NBFC versus banks, and how is this credit flow, jo pehle bank, NBFC or MSME ka jo credit flow tha, how this entire sequence is going to come back, and how this banking criteria of lending to the MSME is going to change or not, and how banks can directly start lending to the MSME. I suppose we have got esteemed speakers in this panel. We will try to find out an answer to these questions in this event to come. Thank you so much for giving me this patience here.
Thank you, Mr. Gadia. I would like to call upon Mr. Abhimanyu Munjal, Chairman CII Delhi State, and also the Chairman of the Summit, to deliver his keynote address.
Mr. Munjal. Good morning and namaskar. I think Jyoti has very clearly showed us what banks and finances like to see while giving credit to the MSMEs. Before I get into the notes that I've been thinking about to speak to you guys, I think it's important. Those are good metrics to know, but that cannot be a cheat sheet. Data going in has to be right. Right? There are a lot of people who mistake if it is current ratio is X, this ratio is Y, I will get a loan. So let me force fit. And through my talks, I will also speak on governance. I think it's important responsibility of this industry and of MSMEs to prove that they are highly governed, especially in times of today, where we are seeing a lot of flight to quality towards more governed companies, whether it be MSMEs, whether it be SMEs, whether it be mid corporates or large corporates. The NBFC crisis that they have spoken about, and if you actually see what has happened, all the funds from banks and debt markets have gone to the top 5 to 10 NBFCs. The reason? Because they are more governed. So there is a lot of flight to quality in times of stress. So I think that I would like to leave, you know, because I saw Jyoti's pseudo cheat sheet. Don't consider it as a cheat sheet to get loans. Governance should be a very, very important point, and I think that's I will stress about it on in my notes. I know Ms. Our chief guest is not here, Ms. Manakshi Lethi. I think she had a death in the neighborhood, and she should be here joining us soon. Dr. Rajesh Yadhuvanshi, Mr. Somany, Mr. Vijay Kumar, Jyoti, friends from media and members of the Confederation, I extend a very warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for joining in at the Delhi SME Summit today. It is great to see such an enormous gathering in this conference today, and not only today, for the last 2 years when I've been here. I've been chairing this. SME Finance Summit is a flagship summit of CII Delhi office. Over the years, the summit has witnessed increased participation from SME as well as banks, NBFCs and ministries. In the light of the 5 trillion economy aspiration that the finance minister announced, India is expected to emerge as one of the leading economies in the world over the next decade. And this cannot happen without the small and medium enterprise, because they play a significant role in the Indian economy. The development of this segment is extremely critical to meet all national imperatives of financial inclusion, generation of significant levels of employment across urban and rural India. As per the 6th economic census, the total SME employment, total SMEs and the employments stand at 51 million SMEs, which employ about 112 million people. 70% of this SMEs establishments, 70% of the total SME establishments, and more than 70% of individuals are in the top 10 states of the country. The government of India in the past 5 years have taken many positive steps towards the SME sector. This includes re-implementation of public procurement policy, Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana, Make in India, Startup India, and Skill India, aimed at increasing growth of manufacturing sector by 12 to 14% annually and increase its share to GDP to about 25% by 2025. The government plans to make a financial and technical support for more accessibility. We welcome all these initiatives from you, sir. These initiatives can nurture and support development of new age entrepreneurs who have the potential to create globally competitive businesses in India. The SME opportunity in India is to develop entrepreneurship and support growth-led innovation models in the next decade. Besides being highly resilient with greater capital productivity, the sector also contributes greatly towards reducing regional disparities and raising socio-economic empowerment. Therefore, the sector offers tremendous growth potentials which may facilitate double-digit growth to the nation. The major advantage of this sector is its employment potential at low capital cost. The labor intensity of SME sector is much higher than large companies. With this agility and dynamism, the sector has shown admirable innovativeness and adaptability to survive the recent economic downturn and recession. The SME sector has slowly come into limelight with increased focus on government and government institutions, corporate bodies and banks. Policy-based changes, investments, globalization, India's growth story has opened several latent business opportunities for the sector. Of the many challenges impeding the growth or development of SMEs, limited access to financial resources, lack of infrastructure support, and inadequate linkages to domestic and global market, etc., are few of the bottlenecks that make these enterprises vulnerable, particularly in periods of economic downturn. As majority of membership of CII companies comprise of SMEs, this sector always has been our priority agenda. CII is working towards on the issue faced by sector through policy advocacy, dialogues with the government, which Mr. Somany can speak about in his keynote. Every business, small or big, faces roadblocks and hindrances. SME in India have huge challenge to sustain today's market. A major chunk of SMEs are reluctant to use technology in their day-to-day business and communication activities. They still rely on traditional activities and convey products and services which are much costlier than the Western worlds. The scenario in other parts of the world is very different. Every major startup country like US, UK and China have advanced visions of technology, be it manufacturing sector or any other industry. Some of Indian SMEs have started embracing the power of technology and using efficiently to smoothen the process, but still India SMEs have merely scratched the surface. So I urge you all to start using and think of innovative models to become more cost competitive in the world. Another area I feel SME business should seriously look at, which I spoke about earlier, is governance and compliance. For business to be ready and to be taken upon challenges in the future, it's essential that we practice good governance within the organization. I feel good governance should be at the top of the agenda of any organization and not just a checklist which is ticked off. First and foremost, it's all about making sure that you meet all your regulatory compliances. That's effectively your right to operate. It is also about making sure your business delivers its strategy, which goes to maximize the opportunity and minimize the risk for the benefit of all its stakeholders. You need to build that into your company. One of CII's most distinct endeavors for enhancing competitiveness has been capability building through cluster programs. The concept of cluster offers new insights for potential role of SMEs. CII, through its Center of Excellence, has been propagating cluster approach to enhance competitiveness and linkages with large industry of SMEs. So I would urge you all to use the Center of Excellence. There are enough use cases in other parts of the country where SME membership have found the Center of Excellence as very valuable to become more competitive. So, Subhash, do we have any Center of Excellence presenting today?
Mr. Somany, okay. Center of Excellence is the Chandigarh one.
Yeah.
MSME clusters and SMEs.
Yeah.
That's a very important thing. If we can take through the
part, so if you can take through them, I think that's something which I would urge all membership to use, because it's a very powerful center of excellence. Apart from these challenges, there are a few regulatory challenges that make the environment tough for SMEs. A large number of MSME units are facing difficulties to obtain EM Part 2 due to cumbersome procedures with MCD, licenses, NOC with Delhi Pollution Control Committee. Because of these, MSMEs are unable to get benefit under the various government schemes. The availability of land for industrial use is a major bottleneck for entrepreneurs in Delhi. More flatted factory complexes, we need to overcome this problem. Some of the state government agencies, PSUs, do not recognize NSIC certificates and insist on earnest money. Also, I believe the definition of MSMEs should change across banks and financial institutions. I think it's something that needs to be looked at. The source of finance for SMEs are limited. Most of the SMEs are self-financed. A major concern for the growth of SME sector has been non-availability of easy finance. Not all small and medium enterprises get funded by traditional banks, courtesy lack of experience, absence of collateral and infrastructure, poor financials, small ticket size, and in today's banking climate, it seems even more difficult than before. In rural areas, percentage of self-finance stands at 72.7%, and that in urban areas is 83.7%. The segment requires heavy investment from capital to actually run adequately. Throughout the day, we would focus on pertinent issues faced by SMEs in India, like access of finance. There would be a session to focus on alternative sources of easy finance. We hope you would find the conference useful and informative. There would be a discussion on GST and other policy initiatives taken by the government in the last session of today's conference. There would be a session which will address imminent need of adequate insurance coverage for all. Lastly, for your ease, we have provided kiosks outside the hall, and there are loan counselors from different organizations. During the day, you may take a visit on the kiosks and halls and stalls. And if you're carrying your documents, please get them scrutinized from these counselors to get instant soft approvals today. I really hope that each one of you take something back from the summit today, and thank you.